Hello friends, welcome to my channel Physics Boy. I am making a series of videos for you on JES 2018 solved paper. Now I am going to discuss part B from JES 2018. You will also get solution of part A and part C on this YouTube channel. In this video, I am solving the perturbation problem of harmonic oscillator from part B JES 2018. The question was, a harmonic oscillator has the following Hamiltonian. It is perturbed with a potential V is equal to lambda times x to the power 4. Sum of the matrix elements of x square in terms of the expectation value in the ground state are given as follows, where kn is the normalized eigenstate of h naught corresponding to the eigenvalue en is equal to h cut omega times n plus half. Suppose del E naught and del E1 denote the energy correction of the order of lambda to the ground state and the first excited state respectively. What is the fraction of del E1 by del E0? Now I am going to solve this question in three different methods. So watch this video till the end to get three different types of solution, which will also help you for future examination. Okay, let me first write the first order energy correction of harmonic oscillator for any state due to perturbation term lambda x to the power 4. Del En is equal to lambda times bra n x to the power 4 ket n. Let's say this is the equation 1. Remember this equation because I will recall this general equation after few seconds. You know for ground state n is equal to 0. So from equation 1 you can write the first order energy correction of the ground state del E naught is equal to lambda bra 0 x to the power 4 ket 0. Just put the value of n is equal to 0 on the equation 1, then you will get this equation number 2. This is the first order energy correction of harmonic oscillator. And you know for harmonic oscillator, position operator can be written in terms of creation and annihilation operator like this. Now taking the square both sides, we get x square is equal to h cut by 2m omega times a square plus a dagger square plus a dagger plus a dagger a. Now from equation 2 we can write this equation. Look at this equation. Here I just split x to the power 4 term into two parts. Now inserting x square from the above equation we get this equation. Now you can simplify right hand side of this equation like this. Now look at the first term on the right hand side of this equation. Here annihilation operator operating on zero state twice, so this will give you zero value. Now look at the second term on the right hand side of this equation. Here the creation operator operating on zero state twice, so it will rise zero state twice, so this will give you square root of 2 times bra 0 x square ket 2. Now look at the third term. At first you have to operate creation operator once, then you have to operate annihilation operator, so this term will give you bra 0 x square ket 0. And finally look at the fourth term, where you have to apply annihilation operator on 0 state, so this will give you 0. So fourth term is equal to 0. So among this fourth term we have two non-zero term. Now the matrix element of x square in terms of its expectation value in the ground state is given in the question. So inserting these values we get the first order energy correction of harmonic oscillator on ground state is equal to h cut square lambda by 2m omega times 3c. Now for first excited state n is equal to 1. So if you put n is equal to 1 on the equation 1, then you will get first order energy correction of the first excited state del E1 is equal to lambda bra 1 x to the power 4 ket 1, which is equal to lambda bra 1 x square times x square ket 1. Now again putting the value of x square from the previous equation we get this equation. Here also we have four terms as in the previous case. Now if you operate creation and annihilation operator on the first excited state in each of these four terms, and if you put the matrix element given in the question, then you will get three non-zero term. So watch this calculation carefully. Now look at the first term on the right hand side of this equation. Here annihilation operator operating on one state, so this will create a zero state. So from this first term we get bra 1 x square a k 0. Now look at the second term, where a creation operator operating on one state, so this will give this term. Similarly, look at the third term, here also a creating operator operating on one state, so by simplifying this third term we get this term. And now look at the fourth term, here a annihilation operator operating on one state, so this will give this term. Each of these four terms contain either creation operator or annihilation operator. Again, by simplifying this four term one by one, we get first term is equal to 0, second term is equal to this, and third term equal to this, fourth term equal to this. Now the matrix element of x square in terms of its expectation value in the ground state is given in the question. So by inserting these values, we get first order energy correction of harmonic oscillator on the first excited state is equal to 15c lambda h cut square by 2m omega. Finally, we get both energy corrections. So the ratio of these two energy correction is equal to 5. So correct answer is 5. Now I am going to discuss the second method. This is the given Hamiltonian of one-dimensional harmonic oscillator with perturbation lambda x to the power 4. You know the ground state wave function of harmonic oscillator is written as psi naught, which is equal to m omega by pi h cut whole to the power 1/4 times e to the power minus m omega x square by 2 h cut, and the wave function of the first excited state of harmonic oscillator is written as psi 1, which is equal to m omega by pi h cut whole to the power 1/4 times square root of 2 m omega by h cut times x times e to the power m omega x square by 2 h cut. Now you have to calculate the ratio of first order energy correction of first excited state and first order energy correction of ground state of simple harmonic oscillator. At first, I am going to find first order energy correction for the ground state from the time independent perturbation theory. First order energy correction of ground state del E naught is equal to k psi 0 lambda x to the power 4 bra psi 0. Now, by putting the value of ground state wave function psi 0 here, we get this equation. Now, you see that here we have to evaluate this integration. We can use this general formula to perform this type of integration. Here we have x to the power 4 term. So we have to put n is equal to 2 in this general formula. Nothing else. Now come back to the energy correction formula after putting the value of this integration. So we end up with the value of del E naught is equal to 3 lambda h cut square by 4 m square omega square. Similarly, we have to find the first order energy correction of the first excited state. Here we have to insert wave function of the first excited state of the harmonic oscillator. As in the previous case, here also we have to evaluate this integration. The only difference is here x to the power 6 term is present instead of x to the power 4 term. So by putting the value of n3 in the general integration formula, as I said earlier, after inserting this value of integration, we end up with the value of del E1, which is equal to 15 lambda h cut square by 4 m square omega square. So the ratio is 5. For this question, you must be answered by integers of 4 digits in JST exam. So the answer is 0005. Now I am going to discuss the third method to solve this question. Here just you have to remember a general formula of harmonic oscillator, nothing else. Then you can solve this type of problem in a very short time. Okay, the formula is the first order energy correction of harmonic oscillator for any state due to perturbating term lambda x to the power 4 is equal to this, where x is given by this equation. If you put the value of x in this equation, then you will get a general formula which is equal to lambda h cut square by 4 m square omega square times 6 n square plus 6 n plus 3. Now, to find the first order energy correction of ground state, you have to put n is equal to 0, then you will get, and to calculate the first order energy correction of the first excited state, you have to put n is equal to 1 in this formula, then you can find the ratio of these two terms, which is equal to 5. Now I am going to share a tips and tricks for upcoming examination and for any future examination. Okay, I already discussed a formula that if the perturbating term contains x to the power 4 term, then you can calculate first order energy correction of any state like ground state or first excited state or second excited state and so on. By using this formula, you have to just put the value of n is equal to 0 for ground state and for n is equal to 1 for first excited state and so on. Now, if the perturbating term contains x squared term, then you can calculate first order energy correction of any state by using this formula. You have to just put the value of n only, nothing else. Now, if the perturbating term contains x or x cubed term or any odd power of x term, then the energy correction of any state will be 0. If you, as I said in the beginning of this video, you will also get remaining solution on my YouTube channel. So stay tuned with Physics Boy. If you have any query or any suggestion, then please feel free to write me on the comment section of this video. If this video is helpful, then don't forget to share it with your friends. Subscribe to our channel by clicking the subscribe button and click the bell icon to enjoy the latest uploads from our channel.